Many years ago, I lived in old Shanghai. Like all the foreigners stationed there, I enjoyed some very special privileges. We almost forgot about the tough times back home. The Depression never touched us in Shanghai. The Paris of the Orient. It was a terrible time to be Chinese. But nothing seemed to bother us. We were there for a good time.
Dr. Payne, I'd like you to meet Mr. Hao Ming. I suppose you could say we're colleagues. Dr. Robert Payne is my American friend. When he's not dancing, he's a surgeon.
I'm delighted to meet you, Dr. Payne. Actually, you and I are in similar business. So, let's have a toast. For similar business.
Similar business.
Yes. If something bad is growing inside one of your patients, you cut that out, make him better again. I operate on society. Society is my patient. And if necessary, I too use a knife. So we are both doctors. The difference is you use a knife to cure, I use it to care.
Is this the
Plum Blossom apartment?
Yes, this is Plum Blossom, but that apartment's empty. Nobody lives there.
Someone told me there's a doctor living here.
And the doctor isn't there. He's here.
You?
I'm Robert Payne. I'm an American doctor.
My husband is ill. It's serious. I've come to ask for your help.
I'm sorry. It's not that I don't want to help, it's just... It's very late. Besides, whoever gave you my address should have known. It's a hospital policy. We never pay house visits. Not just for a
Chinaman. I recall your Hippocratic oath. I shall carry out this work in a pure and a sacred spirit, so long as it's for the good of the sick. I shall go into the house of any man.
Untie him. Take off his shirt. Gunshot wounds from at least 5 different occasions, as well as other wounds caused by a hand grenade exploding at close range. I suspect that some of those fragments are still inside of him, causing some sort of an epilepsy. He is living in excruciating pain. I left my business card, and I want you to come by the hospital tomorrow for some painkillers.
Okay.
What's your name?
Qiu Qiu.
Well, my guess is as good as my diagnosis. This man's not your husband.
Sorry, Dr. Payne. This prescription needs the chairman's signature.
I'll ask the chairman to sign it tomorrow.
Well,
come on, don't worry. I'll have him sign it for you first thing in the morning. American? I'm a doctor. I'm an American! I am a doctor! Never do this, but the girl was sick. She gave me a lot of money, so I came here with her. Her husband was very ill, so I gave him an injection.
What does this man look like?
He was thin, average Chinese.
How old was he?
About 40.
What about the woman?
She's much younger than the man. Just an ordinary girl. Of course, she was very beautiful. Are you sure they're the communists you're looking for? Why did you do this? You said you were looking for two communists. And these people had nothing to do with this. I don't understand. These old women. These children. Do you think they're communists? Hao Ming!
I had an idealistic youth. We were naive and believed Russia's revolution was soon to be our victory too. It's very romantic to follow your ideals. But have you ever thought of the price you will have to pay? from that day. My daughter thought I was a monster. She wouldn't see me.
Finally, my wife sent her away without telling me.
What about your wife?
She committed suicide.
And you never looked for your daughter?
Mr. Payne, is my story interesting?
Don't explain to me anymore. The only thing I know is that you've been arrested, and that's fact. I will not allow these kinds of things to happen in my hospital. The political situation in Shanghai is very complicated. You may not understand, but I do. From now, you will be temporarily replaced by Dr. John.
What am I going to do?
You're only to do your rounds in the wards. We'll talk about your job after things cool down. You have to understand that it's good for the hospital, and it'll be better for you this way. Now, Dr. Zhang is moving into your office. Go clean it out.
Doctor! Has the chairman signed the prescription yet?
Please, some other time, okay?
This job, you know.
Dr. Payne, I'm sorry, but I have no choice. It's the chairman's orders.
It's okay. It's okay.
Dr. Payne, sorry I missed you yesterday. I had a little something to take care of. Can I get that prescription?Are you okay?
I don't know you. Where did you come from? Because where I come from, you are not supposed to end up with a gun to your head when you try to help someone.
Please listen to me.
I almost lost everything because of you. And now that may not mean anything to you.Or your husband. But this is my life.
But
No. I don't want to hear about it. What? In fact, I don't want you here right now. Please leave.
I'm really sorry.
Why are you still standing there? I am asking you to get out of my office. I don't want to be used by you anymore.
So, we are the people they want to arrest.
我不愿意让你们看见我这个样子。对不起啊，我不是来看的，我是来参加的，参加红军。出去！给你。念。啊？念呢？
太阳出来了，一只鹰从地面飞上天空，忽然在空中停住，仿佛凝固在蓝天上。谁也说不清。 为什么飞？他需要什么？Didn't get to head north and join a student army to fight in the Japanese like I wanted. I accepted a secret task to act as Jin's wife. The party leaders decided we would stay in Shanghai for treatment of his sickness. I didn't understand why they picked me. But I felt lucky, because I had finally become one of his soldiers. Are you afraid?
How is he?
He's much better now. He wants to meet you.
Robert Payne. So you're Dr. Payne. Please forgive me, but I can't reveal my real name. You can call me Jin. Ah, if I had this on the Long March, it would have been a real luxury. Last year, at this time, we had fought our way to Guizhou, but no one had a map showing the whole country. Finally, we found one in a church, but all the towns' names were in Italian.So, we had to take the Italian missionary with us. His job was to decipher and to translate the map. And in return, we had to provide him with his own stretcher.
Amazing. It's as if all of China is under your feet.
That day will come. But it won't be me standing on top. It'll be the Chinese people.
You're romantic.
It's not about romance. This is about conviction.
Do you really believe you're going to win?
Definitely. Your own experience should be enough proof of that.
My experience?
You saw how they arrested all those people when they were only looking for the two of us? What do you think they're afraid of? The people are waking up.
Pardon me, Jin.But I heard the million-strong army of Chiang Kai-shek had wiped out the Red Army.
Here's one of them standing in front of you right now. That's why I came here, to show everyone that the Red Army has not been exterminated. And we're still fighting for our ideals.
Is that why you risked your life coming to Shanghai?
Didn't you call me a romantic? There is a reason why I asked you here today. We really want the outside world to know more about what's going on in China, especially Westerners. What if you were to put your own personal experiences in an article? Now, that would make an interesting story.
How did you know?That I wrote articles.
The China Review has a lot of readers in Shanghai. That's how Qiu Qiu knew about you.
You look completely different from when you were sick.
You mean I looked terrible before? Well, our first meeting was under rather unusual circumstances.
I'm a doctor. I can't evaluate someone from an aesthetic point of view, but I still think you should come into the hospital for a checkup. I can arrange that. And don't be concerned. I'm a much better doctor than I am a writer.
I'll think about it. You see, my condition is not such a big deal. These are old wounds from years ago. I'm fine.
Can I ask you a personal question?
Yes, of course.
Are you Jojo's husband?
What? Husband? You don't really understand us. We're not a couple. We're comrades. My wife was murdered 5 years ago.
I'm sorry.
Well, thank you very much for coming to see me. We must leave now. Could you leave a half hour later?
Jen, come to the hospital for a checkup.
I'll let you know. Don't forget to lock the door when you leave.
My grandfather was in Her Majesty's Navy. Sailed over here last century. The one thing that he brought back with him was a small embroidered shoe. I still remember the scent. He said it belonged to a beautiful woman who was as delicate and dainty as a shoe was beautiful. He fell in love with her, you see. The sailor can't bring back a live person. So he was forced to kill her. Brought back a shoe as remembrance. Before I came over here, he took me aside. He said, never get involved emotionally with an Oriental woman, because there's only two ways to deal with them. Do you know what they are?
Money or a knife.
What do you know?
It's the fifth time you've told your grandfather's story.
Oh, Christ. Why didn't you tell me? Sorry.
You broke my glass.
Me? You should talk to her about that.
Pusawa, pusawa!
You should apologize.
I'm sorry.
Get up!
Clark, Clark, don't. Don't. It's not his fault.
It's not her fault. This is a concession. We have our rules.
I was gonna win. If you hadn't come along, no. If she hadn't come along, I was gonna beat him. Black and blue and red and.
If only the chair hadn't gotten in the way.
Yeah, well, it was a very big chair.
Yeah, look, you're drunk. Go home.
I am home. You're drunk.
No, you're drunk.
No, you're drunk. You're drunk.
Look, we'll settle this tomorrow. Good night.
You're drunk.
Very funny. Pain. Pain?
I'm coming, Pain. I'm coming. Oh, good Lord. Are you all right? Come on, Pain, get up. Oh, dear. This isn't fair, Pain. Come on. Pain. Ah, you're here to see him, are you? Hello. Allow me to introduce myself. I'm Colonel Clark.
Glad to meet you.
I'm his best friend.
Oh, really?
I see. Well, I'll leave him in your more than capable hands. Good night.
Good night.
Good night, you lucky dog.
If I didn't know any better, I'd think you were a professional nurse. Where did you learn all this?
In the missionary school, where I grew up.
Is that where you learned English?
Yes.
Him too?
Who?
Your husband.
He studied abroad. He was a teacher before joining the communists.
Are you in love with him? I mean, real love.
Why are you asking me that?
Unusual love experience. It's like this dream. Please, forgive me for asking, but I need to know. Is there a place for me in this story?
Yes, there is a place.
Where? Where is my place? Please tell me.
As the doctor.
Are you turning me away?
do to hear my story.为什么飞？他需要什
围巾呢？
什么？
那红色的，你把它丢了？
啊，没有，没有。
去，去哪去啊？安霞，你看。安霞。不是在这儿吗？
He thought of me as his wife. That's why I've been looking for you. We needed to make him healthy again. Then I can ask him to tell me the truth. whether he loves me or not.
Thank you. Hey, Happy New Year.
Thank you. Happy New Year.
You're not dancing.
No.
Should be dancing.
Okay.
Dr. Bolton, Happy New Year.
Happy New Year, Doctor.
Or Happy New Year. Ah, oh, Dr. Smith.
Oh, Happy New Year.
Happy New Year. They really went all out.
Hospital, and thank you for your donation last year. I'm so happy that your wife and family could be here, and we will take that donation and build a new wing for the hospital. Name it after you.
Ready. Where's Jen?
In the car.
I'll go to the x-ray room first. You bring him later.
Dr. Penn!
Please, call me Robert.
Robert, what are you doing out here? Why aren't you inside at the dance? Ah, such a beautiful woman. Are you going to introduce her? What are you still mad at me? Everything will be fine in the new year. Miss, let me invite you in for a dance. Accepting responsibility is the most important quality in a man's character. I've always said a man does not mature until he's fallen in love with a woman. You continue to surprise me. Here you found a beautiful woman, and she's Chinese. Love is a very serious thing. I guarantee it, miss, you will be happy with him.
Mr. Chairman, would you like to dance?
I would be delighted.
These attacks, do you hallucinate?
Yes. It's like a dream. I'm in another world. I can't tell whether it's heaven or hell. Strange. Sometimes I want to stay in this dream.
Here's the shrapnel. It's lodged in your skull. This is what's causing the convulsions. It affects the function of your brain, bringing on attacks similar to an epileptic fit. To be honest, Jen, it is amazing that you are still alive.
Don't Do I still have hope?
Take out the shrapnel. It's the only way. Due to its position, the operation is delicate. It does have certain risks.
You mean I could die?
No. No, it's unlikely you'll die, but it could damage your brain tissue, or you could be paralyzed.
Of what?
Or you'd have permanent brain damage. And you'd lose your mental capacity.
No, I don't want that.
Can't be negative. I'm a doctor. This is what I do. Trust me.
How much time do I have?
Every time you have an attack, you face death. You must have the operation.
I would rather die.
That's insane.
No, it's not. There is an old Chinese saying, Shi Si Ru Gui. Death is like returning home.
Remember that woman you told him about? He really is beautiful. Dr. Pan, can you tell me now who she is?
I am not interested in your profession. If you would like to make an appointment,
I'll tell you who she is. She's my daughter. The one I lost 9 years ago.
Ridiculous. You must be mistaken. You're thinking of somebody else.
You don't understand a father's feeling. I lost my wife. I lost my child. I lost my family. For 9 years, I've thought of her every day. I didn't search for her because my only wishwas that she was alive and happy. When I found this, I knew my wish had not come true.
If you're so sure it's her, why didn't you stop her or arrest her?
we all know there's a man behind her. A very big communist. There's an old Chinese saying, 放长线，钓大鱼。Put out a long line, catch a big fish.
Tell your men to move off! Move them back! Get them out of here! Don't shoot! For Christ's sakes, don't shoot! This isn't going to be anything! Hao Ming!
Hao Ming, what are you doing?
Don't shoot! For Christ's sakes, don't shoot! This isn't going to prove anything! Hao Ming!
是一张英俊的脸，蓝眼睛，黄头发，再来不错。哎，哎呀
！I love you，
老三，哎呀，哎呀！
Stupid! Put down that gun. That's an order.
把他放了吧。你没胆量开枪。Let's go, Clark.
Most everyone has their own sad story. My friends told me that I should just forget the whole thing, but I could not. 2 days later, Clark was released by the communists and returned to his office, boasting about how brave he had been. In the days that followed, I lost my job.And my friends abandoned me. I felt totally isolated in this huge, far-off city, only hoping that she would appear again.
I have been looking all over for you. Let's go have a drink at the club. Just you and I. We haven't been for a while.
I don't have the time. I'm very busy right now.
I really need to talk to you. Please, just for a while.
No, I didn't arrest her. I heard Haoming arrested her near some drugstore. It's not really clear how he caught her.
How is she?
Did you see the newspaper? We know what happened. There she was with Haoming. Can you believe? I didn't believe it at first. Think all this was done just for you? Look, it's a very moving story. About the reunion of a father and daughter. But what do you think the bloody communists are gonna do when they see it?
What are you talking about?
Jin's finished. His organization won't trust him ever again. They'll probably get rid of him. That's Haoming's plan. But he could still be a good father to Cho Cho in the bargain.
She'll never accept Haoming as her father. And she'll never betray Jin.
What else can she do? My God, man. Haoming himself used to be a communist. Think about it. A tender young girl like that. On the one hand, she faces the knife. On the other, a rich, tearful father. Look, it's over. Go home, Robert. Go home to America. It's time. You still want to see her?
Can I?
Haoming's having a party tonight. Shanghai Hotel. He's invited all the elite of the city to celebrate his reunion with the daughter he lost 9 years ago. Social event of the year. That's where she'll be.
我们的关系是一个革命者和一个叛徒的关系。
小秋，
小姐，
往后退，往后退，
小姐，
小姐，
快送我打车！
I'm dead. It's only rent. After I die, you can have everything I own.
Here, take whatever you want. I think I still have a typewriter, some empty liquor bottles, and a dead plant. Would you like that?
Doctor, it's not about rent. There's someone looking for you.
What?
My wife and I met in Paris.She studied music, and I studied literature. You could say she led me to join the revolution. For a long time, I followed my convictions because I was following her. After she died,I became a true dedicated revolutionary. Five years ago, I was turned in by a traitor in Hankow. When the enemy came to get me, I happened to be out. My wife was at home alone.They forced her into the room and laid a trap for my return. She got free somehow, but had only one way to save me, to jump out the window. It was a tall building and she was in the air for a long time.It was like something out of the anthology of Russian stories.
The sun rises. An eagle flies toward heaven.
That's right. Remember I told you about my dreams when I fall sick? It's so awful.So beautiful. My wife comes home to me. That night at the safe house outside the city.
亲爱的静，请原谅我这样称呼你。那是因为我在你病中的幻觉里充当了你的妻子。但是我现在想对你说的是，能和你一起为信仰而战，是我生命中的快乐。我真希望我就是你的安霞，在你醒来的时候能陪在你的身边。
To start over again
with Jojo? It's impossible. No one can save her now.
I can save her. The enemy wants me, not her. Please go and tell your friend Clark we can negotiate.I think he'll like the idea.
Jen, have you thought about this? Do you know the price you'll pay?
It's worth it.
Why is he doing this?
Because that's who he is.
说会吗？
不会，是个女的，想你。
你爱我吗？啊。
We're almost there. Just keep breathing.
Chouchou died at childbirth, and I adopted her daughter without hesitation. In 1937, China launched an all-out war against the Japanese invasion. The child and I roamed inland until the Japanese were defeated, and we returned to Shanghai. In May 1949, the People's Liberation Army took control of Shanghai and soon liberated all of China. Throughout it all, we lived together as father and daughter. I had named her Pearl. soaked in crimson red and look upon these smiling faces, I start to understand Chuchu and Jin's choices. They dedicated their love to their ideals. Their spirit lives on in this victory. Suddenly, I discover what is truly romantic. They have followed their passion into history. It is their loyalty to each other and to their cause that deserves to be remembered forever.
Are you Mr. Payne?
Yes.
We have been waiting for you. With the help of the People's Government, we've checked the record and find the remains of Cho Cho. In accordance with your wishes, we have put their ashes together. Is there anything else you or the child need?
Nothing. Just brought her to see them again. Xie xie.
Why don't you go see your mom and dad?
Can I touch them? Daddy?
What is it, sweetie?
I took something.
You did? What?
It's a shrapnel.
Why did they put them together?
It's a Chinese custom. They are a couple, and they should stay together. It doesn't matter whether they are alive or dead. They shouldn't be separated.
Thank you.